Good morning, everyone. We are going to revisit 1 Thessalonians 5, 1 through 6 to look at one more thing before we kind of push forward. So I'm going to pray and we'll dive right into our passage. Father, thank you for giving us another time to study your word and to be changed by it. Father, that's what we want. We want to study your word and for it to continue to impact us and to change us into the image of your Son for your glory. So would you please do that right now? Give us understanding and insight through your Holy Spirit. And it's in Christ that we pray. Amen. Okay, so let's read through this one more time. 1 Thessalonians 5, 1 through 6. Now concerning the times and the seasons, brothers, you have no need to have anything written to you, for you yourselves are fully aware that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. While people are saying there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them as labor pains come upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you are not in darkness, brothers, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all children of light, children of the day. We are not of the night or of the darkness. So then, let us not sleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. So last time we looked at the idea that the coming of the Lord, the second coming, it will be like a thief comes in the night. And people feel safe and secure, but then it will be sudden. And it will be a surprise to many. Just like a thief, we don't expect a thief to break in the middle of the night. So the return of the Lord will be unexpected. It will be at a time when we do not expect him. So the final instruction here, this so then, right here, is really in light of all of this. All of this is what drives this instruction, let us not sleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. So really interesting, we looked at a couple of videos ago, the passage immediately preceding this in chapter 4, the end of chapter 4, and it talked about the resurrection of the dead, the second coming, and how we will be with Christ, everyone will be with Christ, and it ends by saying, comfort one another with these words. Encourage one another with these words, rather. So our knowledge about the end times is meant to affect us in the here and now. Our knowledge of the end times is not just intended for our knowledge, just for our curiosity. Rather, it's intended to affect us in a way. So the resurrection was intended to encourage us, to comfort us in our grieving so that we don't grieve like other people do who don't have hope. That's the change that it was designed to bring. So now this passage here, talking about the timing of the Lord's coming. A lot of Christians disagree on the exact timing. But the point of this passage is, whether you agree with when the time is or not, this is how it should affect all of us. Knowing that it's coming when we don't expect it, we should stay awake and be sober. So let us not sleep, keep awake, be sober. We're going to come back and look at something here in just a second, but I want to take you over here to the book of Matthew, the book of Matthew. Chapter 24, verses 42 through 44. And here, Jesus is teaching his disciples. He's about to die, and he's teaching his disciples about the end times. And right here, he's speaking about the coming of the Lord. He also continues on and talks about, he gives a parable of the 10 virgins and parable of the talents, all to kind of make the same point. But that's kind of summed up here in these few verses. So here it says, therefore, stay awake, for you do not know on what day your Lord is coming. But know this, that if the master of the house had known in what part of the night the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake and would not have let his house be broken into. Therefore, you also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. So we see this same analogy here that Jesus is using as he teaches his disciples. If the master of the house had known in what part of the night the thief was coming, he would have stayed awake. So his staying awake would have happened had he known. So this is really important here in our desiring to stay awake. We recognize that that would happen if we knew what part of the night the thief was coming. And this is part of the beauty behind us not knowing exactly what part of the night the thief is coming. This is the encouragement we need, especially in our flesh. Our flesh's desire is to get away with what we can get away with. But God's desire for us is to be conformed to the image of His Son. And God uses many different means of encouraging us to do that. And this is one of those means. Keeping from us the information that we would need in order to know exactly when Christ is going to return. This makes it so much easier for us. It provides accountability for us to live in the way that God has called us to live. So, since we don't know, if we had known, we would have stayed awake. But we do not know. Therefore, you also must be ready. For the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. So it's helpful for us to not know exactly when the Lord is coming, because that provides the accountability we need back here to let us not sleep, to keep awake, and to be sober. Now, why is it that we keep awake, we're sober? Is it just because we want to be doing that when Jesus comes back? If we're not careful, we can think about this as kind of a roll of the dice. I need to get lucky and be doing the right thing at the right time so that I can make it into heaven. But that is not the purpose of keeping awake and being sober. The purpose of keeping awake and being sober is actually twofold. Number one, it's for us, so that we can confirm and know that we belong to the Lord. And second, it's for everyone else to see that we are children of light, children of the day. The reason that we keep awake and that we're sober is because to us it's daytime. This is who we are. When we keep awake and we're living sober, we're not doing anything other than what we are. My son likes to read this book at night, and it's got different trucks and vehicles in it, and it's got monster trucks, and here's what a monster truck does, and fire truck, here's what a fire truck does. And there's this little pat of buttons that he hits when we get to each new truck, and it makes a sound like that truck does. I know exactly what sound it's going to make when he hits a police car button. I know exactly what sound it's going to make when he hits the excavator button. I expect those things to react according to what they look like. Similarly, we are children of light, children of the day. So the rest of the world, and even we, should expect us to live as though we're children of light and children of the day, not in darkness. Well, what does that look like? We do not do the things that they do. We keep awake. We're sober. We do not sleep. Paul is going to continue to explain what it is to keep awake and to keep sober as we continue reading in 1 Thessalonians 5. But maybe today, what is sufficient for us to chew on is this fact right here. Our keeping awake and being sober, our actions stem from our identity. We don't know when Christ is going to return. So we need to be sure that we are awake and sober and that we are children of light. And if you look and discover that you are not a son of light, a daughter of light, today is the day. Today is the day of your salvation. You do not know when the Lord will return. So turn to Him now while He can still be found. For the rest of us, let's use this knowledge of the end times, not just as a means for us to know more about the end times. It's helpful, it's nice, but the purpose is that it would affect us in the way that we live. Are you being diligent to keep awake and to be sober? This is probably going to be especially powerful for us now as we are in quarantine. We don't have the extra accountability that we had before, meeting together in our church buildings, holding one another accountable. Are you keeping awake and being sober? Or have you fallen asleep? Are you seeking to model Christ-like behavior and attitudes and thoughts? Are you continuing to stay plugged into His Word, continuing to seek the Lord in prayer? Or are you sleeping right now? Let's pray. Father, I thank You for Your Word. I thank You that You give us exactly what we need through Your Word. I thank You that what You've given us in Your Word serves a purpose to change us and affect us, and You have designed it to do that. I thank You for that. Would You give me patience? Give all of us patience as we study Your Word, maybe looking for something and desperately wanting something, and finding it to not be there the way that we wanted. Would You give us patience in that moment and remind us in that moment that You have given us what we need for a reason and that You have kept things from us for a reason? As we await the coming of Your Son, would You help us to not sleep, but to be awake and to be sober, focusing our eyes on You, our Lord and Savior. We love You, God. We thank You for Christ. It's in His name we pray. Amen.